Hello and welcome back to the course of cryptography and system security. Today we are going to see the transposition techniques, key and keyless transition ciphers along with the steganography. We are going to see the topic 1.5, which is related to the key and keyless transposition ciphers and text steganography. Now, transposition ciphers, as we are aware of this particular transposition cipher, that it is a cipher which does not have the substitute of any symbols, rather than it has the shifting of the position of the symbols. And likewise, in substitute ciphers, we are going to substitute the letters or the symbols by some other symbols. But here in the transposition, we are not going to change any letters or any symbols. But here in this case, we are going to change the position or the location of the symbol within that same message and making it jumbled. So it reorders or jumbles the given plain text into the given cipher text. And later on, then we can say we can apply it to the key or we have to make it without key. So it depends on the transmission type that we are going to apply. The transposition ciphers. So first type that we are going to see is a keyless transposition cipher, which is without key. Now the message is converted to the cipher text by either of two permutation techniques. First technique is the text is written into the table column by column and then the transmitted row by row. Second technique is the text is written into the table row by row and then transmitted column by column. Then first technique, that is column by column array, then transmission row by row, is known as a recurrence cipher. Now we are going to see this particular example for the keyless transmission transposition cipher. Suppose we want to transmit the message that is defend the east wall. This is the message that we need to transmit. So arrangement for this particular symbols in the tabulated form is like this: D E F E N T column. This is a kind of diagonal arrangement of the letters. The D H E E A S T W A F. Likewise, we are going to make it a zigzag arrangement for the every letter, and then we are going to send it rowwise. That means, suppose the message is to be transmitted rowwise means D F N T E A T A L. Likewise, and then E E D H E S W L. So this is a method. Probably most of the time, the two rows are being preferred by default, but if it is necessary, we can increase the number of rows. Depends on the number of symbols in the passage. So this is a keyless transposition cipher. Similarly, for another type of method, that is, again, we can arrange the same above message into the tables with four columns. Likewise, D E F E N D the T H E East E A S T W A W. Likewise, so arrangement is row wise, but the column wise transmission would be there. Now the data is being transmitted column wise. The it can read as D N E T L E D E W E T F T A A E H S L. Likewise, so the transmission is column wise. But the arrangement of the data is row-wise, likewise. So this is the second method with which we can transmit the key transmission transposition cipher. In which, in this approach, we can say rather than permuting all the symbols together, we divide the entire plain text into the blocks of the predetermined size, and then permute each block independently. Suppose A want to transmit the message to B. B have an attack. So both A and B agreed to had previously agreed over the block size pi. So the block would be WEHAP, WEHAP, EANA, TEANA, T, TACK. That means X. X is a digital factor that we are going to apply. The last letter X is a bogus character so as to complete the block size of 5. Then A and B is using the following key for the encryption and decryption. 41325 and 12345. So this is for encryption and this is for. Then we can have the transposition cipher in the encryption in the cryptography. The transposition cipher is method of encryption by which the positions held by the units of the plain text are shifted according to the regular system. So cipher text constitutes a permutation of the plain text. Okay, thanks for watching. We are going to continue with the step number 5.